I don't know if you followed the OpenAI drama where Sam Altman was fired on Friday and reintegrated OpenAI only on Monday. But just 2 days before that, there was a big conference named Open Dev Day. And during this conference, he announced a big feature named GPT. So the GPT are custom ChatGPT, customized for a specific task and to which you can share some private data that are useful for you. Because even if ChatGPT has scrolled all the web and know a lot of information, it don't have access, hopefully, to private data. And in architecture, we don't share so much about our project data, so most of the data are inside our company. And that way, if we create some custom GPT, we could use our data for our own work to make it searchable thanks to AI-based chatbot, which is quite a powerful search engine, and we can work with it. But another advantage of GPT is that you can customize all the work environment for a given task. So you could share to your colleague, for example, a GPT to choose and select building material. You could create another GPT for administrative tasks or another one for marketing. So it sounds very powerful. So in this video, we are going to see if it is truly powerful, what we can do with it, how to create a new GPT, and we are going to draw a conclusion if it is a good practice now to create a GPT for your architecture company. So now let's go to my screen to show you how to create a custom GPT. So here you are on my screen and we are going to see how to create a GPT. So here you see the button create a GPT. Customize a version of ChatGPT for a specific purpose. I think the description is very clear. So basically, GPT are a kind of customized version of ChatGPT. And here on this page, we have already some GPT existing. Those GPT are made by OpenAI for now, so by ChatGPT precisely. And currently, I'm using a DALL-E GPT because it's a customized way to use DALL-E. DALL-E is the image generator by OpenAPI. And I use from time to time data analysis GPT, which allow to analyze some file like PDF, CSV, and so on. The other one, I didn't test it yet. Maybe they are interesting. I don't know exactly. But to go, maybe I can go in that one that I don't know a lot. So when we access a GPT, here we have the name of the GPT, we have the about powered by GPT-4, browsing, so we have the capabilities, browsing, advanced data analysis, and DALL-E, now built in GPT-4. And here we have some starter prompt, which give us some idea about what to ask this GPT. But we don't really know if this GPT has custom information or has access to an API. Maybe it's just a configuration. And the configuration is not public. Apparently, it's not possible to see how it is configured. So let's go back to our screen. So here is the screen ChatGPT-4, so it's the default way to use the ChatGPT. So now here you have an explore button that allow to access the GPTs, and here you have a button create a GPT that allow to create your own GPT. So let's click on that button. And here we arrive to a new screen split in two, with at the left a kind of builder using ChatGPT itself. So we are going to talk to ChatGPT to create a GPT. And at the right, we have a kind of preview. So we can test it while we configure it. So I want to create an architecture assistant that can help in finding good architecture solution to build carbon-free building. So it's important theme of topic for architects. We need to find some performance solution to have carbon-free building, or at least a building with low emission of carbon. So here, It is updating the GPT and is going to ask us more questions to be able to configure it. Great choice. Let's name this GPT Eco Arch Guide. Okay, why not? Does this name? Okay. So now the second stage, it will create an image. So it will use DALL-E to create an image. If you are not okay with this image, you could of course upload your own image, or you could ask it to create another image with the guidance for DALL-E. And here at the right, we have not the best one I saw, but let's start with this one for now. It features a modern eco-friendly building with greenery. Okay for now. So currently we have a name, Eco Arch Guide. We have a description, architecture assistant for carbon-free building solution. And we have some predefined starter, conversation starter, which give us some idea how to talk to the GPT. So how to design a carbon-free residential building. Now he asked me other question. To start, what kind of information or advice should it priorize when discussing carbon-free? For example, should it focus more on innovative material, energy efficiency, or cost effectiveness? I think the goal is to inform our choice as an architect of the material and architecture solution we use. Okay. So the step is not long, but he asked several questions. Of course, you could ask more. Should have it with user. Should it be more technical or undetailed or user-friendly and simplify? Think technical, but user-friendly. Yeah, why not? It's possible to be technical and user-friendly. Also, how interactive should it be in terms of skin? Okay, I think about follow-up information, I think it's important to precise that you need to ask some questions, because this way ChatGPT is more efficient when he asks all the questions. He need to have a more precise response. For example, should it? Okay. It should ask all the needed question to have a precise response. Okay, so it's going to probably terminate the configuration. But at the same time, while it is being created, is all set up. It's a professional and approachable architecture assistant focused on carbon-free building solution. It will ask thorough questions to provide precise and relevant advice using a blend of technical terms and clear explanation. Feel free to try out. Okay. What is the best material for a roof in of a house, individual house? Okay. Choosing the best roofing material. Okay. So for now, perhaps it's better than the default GPT, but we are not really sure about that, but we are going to see what we can do else than just asking this kind of question. So here we save. First, we save. So when we save, it could be public. So for now, public, there is no public listing of the GPT, but there will be in the future. Only people with a link. So if you want to share to a colleague or to your team, or only to you. So I will share in people with a link, so I can share it to you at the end of the video. So now we are on our GPT, but I want to configure it a bit more to show you what is possible. So here we have the configure tab. So we have the name of the GPT, the description of the GPT, and the instruction. EcoArch guide should adopt, okay, this is the style focusing. Now we have the conversation starter. So this text basically, it's a kind of custom instruction. I don't know if you already use custom instruction, but in ChatGPT it's possible to add instructions that are used in all the conversation with it. And here the advantage is that you could create different GPT with different custom instructions. So if you are, for example, working on a marketing stuff, you are going to take a custom instruction specialized for marketing. If you are working on architecture, choosing material, you are going to choose to create a GPT for that. And the only thing that it's possible to have a custom instruction specific to a domain, it's already a good step and already useful. After, how we can go further. So first, we have two ways to provide data to the GPT. One is with API, so it is action. And one is with file. So as I don't know exactly if you know what is API and if you use it, I will first talk to you about the file. So here I uploaded a file by AEI that talk about building performance. So it's a PDF like this, a PDF with some data about building performance. So probably it will be a good documentation for this GPT. And the advantage is that all these texts will be now available to ChatGPT, and I could ask it some question about it. So here is a guide. After, I want it to trust my text more than the other information he has, because I want it to be, I know that my texts are correct, 100% correct. And one of the problems of the AI is that you are not always sure if the information is truthful. So I will leave it a message. Please use the information. So maybe, okay, I will not put here because I want to have a response from ChatGPT. So unpublished change. Okay. I can update. So here all my users will have this data to work with. But of course, you can upload as much file as you want. So imagine you have many files that document all your project in your studio, in your company. It's very useful because it could have access to this data, which is private. So he has no access to this data when he was trained. So I think is one other very very important advantage of GPTs. So here I say, okay, I uploaded a file already. Can you always refer to that file first as a truthful source? I think it will accept. Generally, it is very open. So now I will just try according to the guide of performance of AI, what are the five more important way? Okay, so he says that it's this file particularly is his primary source of information. Okay, so I say no. Okay, I will go back to configure because I want to check. Okay, yeah, you see the primary source of information for GPT is a user uploaded document titled AEI BSP Guide 2019 Final. So it's very clear here, and I prefer to ask it to add it to the instructions than adding it myself, because I know that he will write better something he understands. According to the guide of performance, what are the more important aspects of building performance. So the possibility to upload some file is really the game changer of this GPT. It means that you could give access to some private file and give access to other people without sharing the file itself, I don't know, a wiki, for example. But contrary to the wiki, you have the possibility to chat to it. So it means that you could have a really big document that is used on a daily basis by your company members. And this is very great, very good. After, just to name it quickly, we are going to see what's inside the action. So action, basically, it expects a JSON schema. So schema is a definition of your API connection. And an API is a way to talk to an external service that gives some data. So if you are aware about the open data movement, where public organizations need to share their data, so they have an API to share. And if you have this API, if you have the access, you could configure ChatGPT to call this API. So to call this API, maybe at the beginning of the conversation with it to get the information, maybe, or to call the API to make some modification if you can store some data. And this is where it starts to be more powerful. But as it is an advanced usage, I will not talk in depth in this video. And maybe if you want, I will make a new video about this API connection. So if you have a good idea of GPT, please share in the comment. And thank you to attend this video, to subscribe to the channel. I will release more videos about AI and ChatGPT. So please continue to follow this AI in AOC journey. Bye-bye.